Hi, welcome to Dr. Welling's Health Show. Today, let's discuss low AMH, diet, and conceiving naturally. At Welling Clinics, we have specialty infertility homeopathic treatment to help women conceive naturally without the need for artificial treatments like IVF. Now, as we have consulted and helped women with low and very low AMH, we noticed a lot of women with low AMH go for artificial treatments as a first option, as they are wrongly advised that they cannot conceive naturally. Also, they panic and rush as they are further wrongly advised that with low AMH, their time is limited to conceive. And we advise exactly the opposite. We have helped a lot of women conceive naturally with right homeopathic medicines and some dietary advice. And today I'm going to discuss most of the dietary advice that we give to our patients. Watch the full video as it is very exhaustive and full of tips. So the developing egg sacs or ovarian follicles secrete AMH. The more eggs there are remaining in the ovaries, the higher the level of AMH in your bloodstream. So a low level of AMH is thought to be a sign of low ovarian reserve, low number of developing egg sacs. And a low level of AMH is normal for a woman nearing menopause. A normal AMH level is considered to be 1 to 3 ng per ml. A very low AMH is considered to be around 1.05 ng. It is also important to note that if you have PCOS, you can have higher than normal egg count and so AMH levels. The anti-mullerian hormone is tightly related to the issues of fertility and of higher importance for those who are trying to conceive. It has been used as an ovarian reserve marker since 2002. The ovarian reserve is also a strong indicator of the pregnancy treatment outcome. However, following these strategies can help a lot of women. And if these don't help in a limited time, you can always visit or consult a specialist at Welling Clinic near you. Make sure you are getting enough vitamin D. Now, vitamin D plays a key role in egg survival and growth. Some foods like fish, salmon, and eggs contain a small amount of vitamin D. But most of our vitamin D comes from sun. On average, we need 10 minutes of direct sunlight or 30 minutes outdoors on a cloudy day to meet our vitamin D requirements. That's all. Make sure you are doing regular exercise. Although this strategy only seems to be helpful for women who are overweight or who have PCOS, do a 45-minute walk 3 times per week and doing your exercise outside, you can get some vitamin D at the same time. L-arginine, an amino acid which is there in most protein supplements, is known to improve ovarian function. If you are trying to conceive, one of the things you should take care of most in your diet and nutrition. Eating wholesome and balanced foods will provide you with plenty of nutrition that is required to keep your reproductive system healthy, your hormones stable, and improve your circulation. A rainbow diet, which includes a wide array of colorful fruits and vegetables, is one of the best way to include in a high amount of nutrition in your meals. Some of the most important nutrients needed to boost fertility are iron, fibers, carbohydrates, non-saturated fats, that's good fats, vegetable proteins, high-fat dairy, and plenty of vitamins and folic acid. Avocados are a superfood, meaning they are jam-packed with nutrition. Their high content of monounsaturated fat helps in improving egg health and maintaining good reproductive health. They can be used in sandwiches, salads, and spreads. Incorporating beans and lentils into your diet would improve much needed iron level in your blood. Vitamin B complex, magnesium, and other essential nutrients that are vital for fertility. It is important to include at least one portion of beans and lentils in your diet every day. Dried fruits and nuts are a great source of proteins, vitamins, minerals and antioxidants. Especially almonds and walnuts are very high in selenium, which is a mineral that prevents chromosomal damage in eggs. It is also an antioxidant that keeps free radicals at bay and allows better egg production. You can add almonds, walnuts, peanuts and cashews to smoothies or salads or your main dish even. Spinach, cabbage, broccoli and cauliflower and other leafy vegetables are high in folate, iron, magnesium, calcium, even vitamin A, B, C and E. These nutrients are essential in strengthening and maintaining your health of your eggs. Include at least 2 portions of green vegetables in your diet every day. Cinnamon is known to improve ovarian function and encourage proper egg production by combating the insulin resistance. This is especially useful for women who have been diagnosed with polycystic ovarian syndrome, that is PCOS. Adding cinnamon to your diet if you have PCOS or want to boost your fertility is surely advised. A quarter teaspoon of cinnamon consumed on a daily basis can be very helpful. Here I want to tell you one important thing. Women with very low AMH levels can still get pregnant if the quality of egg is good. Hence, the goal of your fertility treatment should be to enhance the quality of your eggs. If a woman has low ovarian reserve and has not conceived within 6 months of trying with these above steps, I would suggest visiting a Welling Clinic fertility specialist for an early investigation and advice. That's all in today's episode. See you in my next episode tomorrow. Comment below your questions and queries if any. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel to get regular updates. Bye and take care.